Hello everyone, my name is Pratik Dabhade and I am here to explain about Cosmic Ray Muon Detector on the occasion of National Science Day 2021. So what are cosmic rays? Cosmic rays were discovered by Victor Franz Hess in 1912 when he took a solo flight up in the altitude to about 17,000 feet and found that the radiation detected was twice at higher altitude than the sea level, and that explained that the origin of this cosmic rays or this radiation was from away from Earth and not locally on Earth. So these cosmic rays also produce very magnificent features which are visible in the northern and southern part of the Earth, called the aurora borealis or the northern lights in the northern hemisphere. These occur due to the interaction of the cosmic rays with the magnetic field of the Earth. So what are the origins of this high energy cosmic rays? The cosmic rays can have energies up to 10 raised to 21 eV. This is the maximum it has been observed ever, and it is conjectured that there are cosmic accelerators in terms of supernovae remnants in our galaxy which are capable of accelerating these particles to very very high energy levels, and hence they are able to travel longer distances. Another objects are thought to be the black holes, which are even bigger and very powerful progenitors for the cosmic rays, and also the gamma ray bursts. However, localizing the source of cosmic rays is a very difficult task, because the cosmic rays, which are mostly proton, they are charged and they travel through magnetic field in various environments, and hence their paths can be deflected, and therefore the localizing is extremely difficult. Pere Auger Observatory in Argentina is one such observatory which is determined to locate the origins of this cosmic ray, study their properties and understand their workings in detail. So the primary cosmic ray, like I mentioned before, is a mostly a proton which travels from outer space, from our galactic or extragalactic environment, and interacts with our Earth's atmosphere to create a cascade of particles, eventually leading to the particle of interest, muon. And the pions, which are product of this main cosmic ray proton, are the ones directly responsible for creation of muon and neutrino. And muons are part of this standard model of particle physics in the leptons family. These are almost 200 times the mass of electron. They are called the heavier cousin of electron, and they also decay in electron and neutrino, which is essential for their detection, because we get a signal of electron upon their decay, and that's how it is possible to detect them. So we have one such detector at IUCA, which was built almost 10 years back by myself and one of my colleagues under the guidance of Professor Joydeep Bakshi. So this is our setup, which consists of a scintillator which is made of a polyvinyl toluene, which is sensitive to any ionizing radiation. Whenever a muon passes through it, it will give a flash of light which will be captured by a photomultiplier tube, as you can see on the screen, which is connected to the scintillator, and all this is covered so that no other light is able to cause the false detection. So, and the signals are then passed to the data acquisition board, which are then collected to the computer and for further processing of analysis of data. So why do we study them? It is very essential to study muons because they give a proof of Einstein's special theory of relativity, where we can test the time dilation as muons are traveling at relativistic speed. So the time in their frame and the time in our frame differs, and that is a direct effect of special relativity. And by detecting them at different heights, we can test this theory of relativity. They also have application in muon tomography of mapping hidden structures, as well as they can act as radiation detectors. You may have heard of the Large Hadron Collider in CERN, which detected the Higgs boson, and the muon detectors were very crucial for detecting this particle, as the decay signature involves muon. Thank you. For more information, please have a visit at the website given on the slide. Thank you.